conducting critical research, pioneering approaches, and advocating for more equitable and effective policies, the contributions of Howard School of Education can be seen from the classroom to the courtroom, from academia to Capitol Hill.
The School of Education is quite a unique school when it comes to the preparation of teachers, administrators, and other professionals in human service delivery. Within public schools, we focus primarily on urban schools. We prepare students to be reflective educators, change agents, educational leaders, and researchers.
And the focus on urban schools is critical as today's classrooms become increasingly diverse.
We have a diverse faculty, we have diverse students, and we teach students how to work with diverse populations.
The school is accredited by the Council for the Accreditation of Educator Preparation. And through a variety of programs offered in the school's three main departments, candidates are steeped in knowledge designed to counter the effects of racism in educational and clinical settings.
The best thing about being a doctoral student with the School of Education, other than my colleagues, are my professors. There's a wide array of expertise amongst them, from equity to culturally relevant pedagogy to policy implementation. We are being fully equipped to serve and to sit at the table to help make the educational experiences of students, specifically in marginalized communities, much better.
Preparing aspiring educators begins in the classroom, where they learn to leverage the strengths and cultures of the communities they serve.
We really believe here at Howard University that we need to focus more on assets for student and community-based strengths rather than weaknesses and deficits. What we teach our students to do is to identify those strengths. What that teacher can do is take that information and use it to build on instruction.
And that assets-focused instruction translates into success for graduates in the field.
My student teaching at Howard was a lot like my own experience as a student. But when I started teaching, the community was more diverse racially, socioeconomically, in every kind of way. But because of my student teaching at Howard, and because of my instruction at Howard, I was able to connect with not only the students who looked like me, lived like me, but also the students who were nothing at all like me on the surface. I was able to connect with them in ways that focused on their strengths. I was able to pull those from the students and bring them into our classroom.
And the School of Education constantly innovates, offering new programs and initiatives to address emerging opportunities and challenges. Partnering with the School Superintendents Association, the school launched the Urban Superintendents Academy, a program that prepares leaders to serve racially and ethnically diverse school districts.
Just as we see the need for improvement in the area of teacher diversity, that also happens to be the same case that we see in administration, and particularly at the executive level. With the advent and the need for more urban superintendents that are reflective of the diverse population that we have, Howard is well positioned to produce the next cadre of superintendents in American urban settings to serve this role.
The School of Education boasts a deep commitment to research. That commitment is clearly seen in the Journal of Negro Education, oldest continuously published journal about black people housed in the School of Education.
Throughout our history, we have published the most prominent historians in African-American education, including Ralph Bunch, W.E.B. Du Bois, Lucy Slough, and Kenneth B. Clark. Today, we continue to be a journal that represents the best and the brightest of black education, and we continue to be independent and autonomous right here at Howard University. The Journal of Negro Education has been a prominent voice in putting out publications that show people how black children achieve, not why they aren't achieving. We've also been a force in challenging the status quo, looking at some of the disparities in funding, not disparities in kids, looking at some of the teacher biases, not the kids' risk factors.
The School of Education is also home to Howard's renowned early learning program, a nationally accredited program serving 3 to 6 year olds. In addition to providing an academically rich learning environment, the program serves as a laboratory where student teachers learn to integrate the educational and developmental theories they're studying with practical experience. Through these and other robust programs, the School of Education prepares men and women for careers marked marked by excellence.
Howard University is an exceptional institution that has made so many contributions to the world, and I think we should take pride in that.
Building on a proud history, Howard University School of Education continues the noble and important work begun so long ago, improving access, expanding opportunities, achieving excellence, past, present, and future.
Good morning, everyone. We're about to start our honors and awards ceremony. I am Dr. Velma LaPointe. I'm the MC, and here's just a few directions. Howard University requires that we are masked. Number two, you want to silence your phones or turn them off. The bathrooms are located downstairs. You will see signs directing you downstairs once you go out the doors. There's also an elevator for people who might need assistance with the steps. The other thing you should know is that I'm not gonna announce each event or person who is speaking. They are listed on your program. The speakers will state their first and last names. We will have an official welcome by the Dean of the School of Education, so you're not necessarily gonna hear a welcome from each person, and it's not that we are being we're not being or showing our manners. It's just that it would be repetitive, and we've got a tight program. There are a few times that you do stand during the program, like when the students are marching in the processional, students and faculty. You will stand. You will also stand at the National Negro Anthem when the little children are singing. The words to the National Negro Anthem are printed in our program. When we leave the auditorium, the day's guest will exit first, and we'll walk down that middle aisle, and then the students will follow the faculty, and the audience members will come after that. We will be headed out that left door, across the yard, and to the undergraduate rooftop library, where we will have a wonderful reception for our students and family members. So without further ado, we will be getting ready to start. Thank you.
Thank you.
Good morning. You may be seated. So wonderful to see you all in person this morning. Welcome to the School of Education Annual Honors and Awards Ceremony. It is my pleasure to bring greetings on behalf of the faculty and staff. This morning, we are happy to celebrate the graduates of three classes, the classes of 2020. 2021. And 2022. Thank you to Ms. Keisha Thorpe for accepting our invitation to bring us an inspirational message to our graduates. As a daughter of Howard University, we are so proud of you. Thank you to the Honors and Awards Committee for bringing us a memorable occasion each year. Thank you for our leadership at Howard University for supporting us, especially during our virtual years. And finally, thank you to the faculty and staff of the School of Education for your commitment and dedication to our students in maintaining a rigorous and relevant academic program. And congratulations now to our graduating class. You did it. You have successfully completed that final paper. You have persevered through that final exam. Those comprehensive exams should be a distant memory now. You logged your final hours in your internship, your practicum, and your student teaching. You passed that certification exam, and you successfully defended that doctoral dissertation. But we know that you did not do this alone. Your village has been here supporting you during your academic journey. A Yoruba proverb states, "If we stand tall, it is because we stand on the backs of those who came before us." So graduates, please stand and salute your village that is here to support you today. Let me take this moment to also say Happy Mother's Day to all of the moms, those that are watching and those that are in the house. I know that many of you carry the testimony, as do I. I am here because my mother prayed for me. And although Father's Day is about a month away, dads, please know that how appreciated you are in the lives of our students during this academic journey. You have made a difference. One of the strongest testaments of your preparation is how highly sought after you all are upon graduation. Right now, as I look at you all beautifully robed, I know that you have professional opportunities in the fall from prestigious graduate schools, K-12 school systems, and nonprofit and government agencies, to name a few. Dr. Michael Brown will continue in his new role as the Minister of Creative Industries and Innovation in the Prime Minister's Cabinet for Antigua and Barbuda, where he also served as the Minister of Education. Mr. Corvon Hill of Human Development will begin his first year in our highly ranked Masters of Social Work program at Howard University. Dr. Cindy DK is working as a mental health assessment coordinator at an outpatient behavioral health agency in Houston, Texas. Ms. Aaliyah Jeffries has accepted a teaching position in Washington, D.C. She was also recognized as our 2022 Distinguished Teacher Candidate. Over the past 2 years, we have witnessed a lot of change. The resurgence of attacks on the use of school curriculum that represents diverse lived experiences is troubling. We find ourselves fighting a history of structural racism while also trying to safeguard our health against a global pandemic. However, what has not changed is Howard University's steadfast commitment to balance the scales for the disenfranchised and promote an America that is devoid of inequalities.
Given your aspirations, you will undoubtedly be faced with the temptation to ignore your training, a training that is steeped in social justice pedagogy and leadership, a training that has taught you to critically look at data to identify hidden patterns that support inequitable practices and policies, a training that holds you accountable to the communities that you serve. We need for you to exercise political courage. Many times we have the data and we know what is right, but we also must develop the political courage to do what is right. There is power in your voice, but there is also noticeable power in your silence. Silence communicates as deeply as anything else. If you ignore your training, you are doing us all a disservice. We have poured into you with the expectations that you will pour into others. To quote the famed author Alice Walker, the most common way people give up their power is by thinking that they don't have any. I hope that the lessons that you've learned at Howard University stay with you as you mature and make life choices that will not only impact you, but your community. So this weekend, as you transition into becoming Howard University alumni, I want you to embrace your inner strength that helped you to get here today. You not only represent Howard University and the School of Education, you are representing the very best of what we have to offer. Make your presence known. Fix that crown. Practice your walk, your entrance, your strut. You cannot leave footprints if you are always walking on tiptoes. Those footprints will be your legacy. As our next generation of educators, leaders, advocates, and activists, you don't have next, you have now. Graduates, let us not only continue to make history, but let's make sure that we are making a difference. Congratulations.
Good morning. My name is Suna Nalo, and I stand before you today, elated and overjoyed to have completed my undergraduate studies at Howard University several decades after I first began that journey. It's a story of passion and of perseverance, of determination, and of the resolve to succeed, irrespective of the challenges that life throws at us. I first entered Howard University as a freshman in August of 1978, with the goal of succeeding in record time. But some curveballs were thrown my way. A difficult relationship that went downhill, a single mother of two girls, the need to work to put food on the table, to be black, to be female, and coming from an immigrant background, all presented overwhelming obstacles where considerations of equality or social justice seemed but a distant dream. The realities of survival dictated my every move. It meant dropping out of Howard, but dropping out did not mean canceling my determination to earn a Howard degree. Instead, it strengthened my resolve to embrace an incremental pace towards success. To surrender was never in my vocabulary. I never gave up, never gave in to the pressures of a challenging life. So I stand before you today with dreams fulfilled, hard work paid off, and failure rejected. I've had a life journey filled with many personal and career milestones. Two daughters who are pursuing postgraduate degrees, one a PhD in epidemiology, and another a master's degree in homeland security. One of those daughters is also a Howard alumna. I've held many amazing jobs, worked for many companies, including being an administrative staff member here at Howard University. I've traveled the world as required for employers, and today I hold the position of regional inclusion, diversity, and equity advisor for an overseas government. My region includes countries in North, South, and Central America, the Caribbean, and overseas territories. So with all my experiences, I hope that my life story is an inspiration to others to stay the course with motivation and passion, as well as new skill sets and lifelong learning to meet the high demands of an often very competitive and very stressful professional and personal life. Langston Hughes once wrote, "Hold fast to dreams, for if dreams die, life is a broken-winged bird that cannot fly." Please allow me to add a few more guiding words. First, give thought to every decision you make, because while impulsivity is exciting, it's not sustainable. Next, take every step with a sense of purpose and intention, because although missteps may be corrected, it often doubles your work and unfortunately in some instances is not recoupable. Next, while it is possible to achieve dreams with hard work and perseverance, I am living proof of this, it is so much easier to seize each day and make the right choices. Next, do not take past and future graduate level coursework for granted. There are reasons to follow guidelines, deadlines, other academic policies and procedures. Remember that those same policies and procedures, such as attendance, punctuality, abilities to read, write, and verbally express yourselves precisely, eloquently, and effectively, are the same policies and procedures that exist in workplace at all levels. Next, make every day count, because living life like a broken-winged bird, not been able to fly, is neither your destiny nor your portion. Remember to live each day as if it's the most important and impactful day of your life, because it is. And finally, I'd like to thank the School of Education faculty, the administrators, as well as the staff, because you helped us to achieve our dreams and goals of matriculating at and graduating from Howard University. Because of your guidance and dedication and your commitment to your students, we're here today celebrating. Congratulations to our Howard University 2022 graduates. Thank you for your time.
Good morning. Good morning. That's better. I'm Dr. Anthony Wooton. I currently serve as the Provost and Chief Academic Officer at Howard University. Before I enter into my comments, I'm going to ask if the class of 2020, 2021, and 2022 will stand for two reasons. First of all, to be acknowledged. And secondly, because you stand as role models for these young Howard University students now. This is my favorite school at Howard University. We have 14 schools and colleges, but my favorite school is the Early Learning Program for a number of reasons. My wife and I have two daughters. Youngest is a sophomore in high school, and the oldest is a rising senior here at Howard University. They both got their educational foundation at Howard University's Child Care Center and in the Early Learning Program. So before my oldest daughter stands where you are standing now next year, she sat where they are sitting 17 years ago. And so you may not realize how much you serve as an inspiration for people you may never know and may never meet again, but you are their role models, and they will stand on your shoulders. And so I congratulate you, and I thank you for what you're going to do that you don't even realize yet. You may be seated. So I want to acknowledge the parents, grandparents, spouses, siblings, uncles, aunts, brothers and sisters, and all other family members who have made this moment possible for our graduates. If it were not for your emotional, your financial, your spiritual support, they would not be here today. And so we stand here watching them in fulfillment of the journey that God has laid out for them. And we're especially excited that we're able to celebrate Commencement 2022 as a traditional Howard University in-person family experience for the first time in 3 years. Our graduates have shown great commitment, diligence, and perseverance as we've navigated a number of challenges over this past year. In addition to the impact of COVID-19, the greatest pandemic that the world has seen in over 100 years, we experienced a major cyber attack on our network in September. HBCUs across the country were impacted by multiple bomb threats, as well as the turbulence of protests and social justice issues, both right here on campus and around the country. But despite these challenges, you have remained faithful and dedicated to the task of completing this important educational milestone. While there are many more races and challenges in front of you, I'm confident that you'll continue to be resilient, persistent, and successful, because that is what a Howard University education has instilled in you. I will close with one of my favorite scriptures to you from the book of Jeremiah, chapter 29, verses 11 through 13. For I know the plans that I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and the future. Then you will call on me and come and pray to me, and I will listen to you. You will seek me and find me when you seek me with all of your heart. God bless you, congratulations, and best wishes.
Good morning. My name is Karen Bussey, and today I will be sharing words of wisdom with my fellow class of 2020, 2021, and 2022 graduates. Commencement marks a remarkable moment for all of us. It is the culmination of many years of hard work, sometimes no sleep, but many memories that we will carry with us forever. The wisdom that I will share with you comes from my own personal journey throughout my life, and especially during my doctoral journey. I come from a small town in South Carolina, North Augusta, to be exact. I attended undergrad at South Carolina State University, the only public four-year HBCU in the state. An institution with a rich culture like Howard University, exceptional graduates, but a tumultuous history steeped in inequities. The first time I advocated for HBCUs was during my freshman year when I traveled to the South Carolina State House with my Student Government Association peers. We advocated for more institutional resources and support from state policymakers. At that time, I didn't know advocating for institutions and students would be my life calling, but here we are many years later. Never did I know those humble beginnings would bring me to Howard University to pursue my doctorate degree, become a policy advisor to a state secretary of higher education, and influence my research and policy lens. I now develop equitable policies based on what I've heard from my family members, friends, and students while working in higher education. As we start a new chapter in our lives, I hope you remember these words of wisdom. First, find your purpose. One of my favorite books is Simon Sinek's book, Start With Your Why. Sinek shares that in any decision you make, you should always ask yourself, why? It is the why that will always humble and ground you as you make decisions. Second, if there's a choice, take it. Take a chance. Often, one of my biggest barriers to growth is me holding myself back. A mentor once told me while I was job searching after completing my master's degree, let the company, as in the company you're interviewing for, tell me no and not the other way around. Many times from fear and imposter syndrome, Some of us may have stopped our own blessings. Just remember that we've already taken a chance on Howard University and we succeeded. We can do it again. Third, welcome the unknown. Our Howard chapter is completed and our next chapter is unknown. Embrace it, smile about it, get excited about it. It is coming. Lastly, from our alma mater, as we sail life's rugged sea, O Howard, we'll sing of thee. Always remember home and share the goodness of Howard University wherever we go. I wish you blessings along the journey and thank you.
Greetings. My name is Olivia Enda. We want to take a moment of reflection to show respect and admiration for those who are unable to be here and those who have passed away. We will remember those beloved family members, classmates, friends, and colleagues who gave unconditional support. We find solace in knowing that they are present in spirit with us. As so eloquently put by Amanda Gorman, the nationally and globally recognized African-American poet. For it is our grief that gives us gratitude, shows us how to find hope if we ever lose it. So ensure that this ache wasn't endured in vain. Do not ignore the pain. Give it purpose. Use it. And now, a moment of silence.
As the children get assembled, they will sing the first verse of the National Negro Anthem. The audience will then join them on the second verse. The words to the National Negro Anthem are printed in your program if you do not know it. When we start, you will stand in honor of that anthem. Thank you.
Yes, it will. God. Oh my God. It's not even worth it. Thank you. dark past has died, let's sing a song full of the faith that the presence has brought us. Facing the rising sun, a mighty day begun. Let us march on till victory.
Our future is bright. These are the children of the Howard University Early Learning Program serving ages 2 years and 9 months to 6 years old. For them to know the words of this song is phenomenal, and that is due largely to their teachers. It is so becoming that this is National Teacher Appreciation Week, and we want to show the Howard University Early Learning Program how much we truly appreciate them. We have a gift basket for you all that I'm sure that you'll enjoy when you get back to the program today. It's kind of heavy, and this time it's supplies and goodies for you and not the students this time. So it's really for you because of the hard work. You have to understand the pandemic impacted all of us. Have you ever done virtual learning with three-year-olds? Well, they did, and they didn't miss a beat, and they were phenomenal, and our children are the testament of that. So teachers, thank you very much for everything that you do and that you have done, and we want to take this moment to celebrate you all.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Jaden Jordan. It is with such honor to introduce our keynote speaker on behalf of the students, faculty, staff, and administration of the School of Education. A Howard alumna, an endorsed principal in Prince George's County Public School, and a teacher, Ms. Keisha Thorpe is the winner of the Varkey Foundation Global Teacher Prize 2021. In partnership with UNESCO, the United Nations Educational, Scientific, and Cultural Organization, she was selected from over 8,000 nominations and applications for the Global Teacher Prize from over 121 countries around the world. Keisha Thorpe currently teaches English to 12th grade students at the International High School in Langley Park, Bladensburg, Maryland. It is a school with 100% English language learners, majority low income, with many immigrant or refugees from Africa, the Middle East, the Caribbean, South, and Central America. Keisha redesigned the 12th grade curriculum for the English department to make it culturally responsive. As a result, the English language learners have shown a major increase in their reading scores. Keisha encourages her high school students to apply for college and provides assistance with their applications. She helped her senior students in 2018 and 2019 alone win over almost $7 million in scholarships to 11 different colleges, with almost all being tuition free. Keisha co-founded US Elite International and has helped over 500 students get full athletic track and field scholarships, where many have achieved college and postgraduate degrees. Keisha also established an annual scholarship and athletic convention where college coaches, admissions, and compliance teams inform economically disadvantaged student athletes about college admissions. Keisha has won numerous awards, such as the Medal of Excellence from Maryland's Governor Larry Hogan for her work in influencing equitable education policies. She was named the National Life Changer of the Year, received the Prince George County Public School Board of Education recognition, and so many more. Keisha believes education is a human right and all students should have access to it at all levels. She wants to be the teacher that champions that for them. I don't know about you all, but I am encouraged. I am super excited to hear such words of wisdom from an inspiration, a trailblazer, and an educator herself. Would you all please stand on your feet and help me provide a warm welcome to our keynote speaker, Ms. Keisha Thorpe.
Thank you so much for that wonderful introduction. Good morning. I am so happy to be here with you today. So if you could oblige me for a minute and bow your heads. Father God, thank you for this day that you have made. Thank you for the opportunity to be a vessel of your words. As I address those you have chosen for this journey today, I pray you transform my words into hope, wisdom, courage, strength, and favor. May the audience of these words not only be receivers of these words, but doers also. And as they embark on this journey to do your work, may you cover them and protect them and gift them with the life more abundantly. In Jesus' name. And everyone say, good morning again, class of 2020, 2021, and 2022. H-U?
You know.
There we go. You made it. Beyond all the challenges and obstacles you encountered to get into this esteemed program, and beyond all the challenges and obstacles you persevered during the pandemic to get to this day, you made it. Look at someone beside you and just say to them, you made it. And so I congratulate you on this huge accomplishment. I would like to say thank you to the president of Howard University, Dr. Wayne Frederick, and Dr. Dawn Miller, Dean of the School of Education, and all those who work behind the scenes to make this day possible. Thank you also for the distinct honor to address the School of Education classes of 2020, 21, and 22. I want to tell you a little bit about my story of a young girl from Jamaica who grew up in poverty and dared to dream of a better life. A young girl who understood the value of education from a grandmother who raised me, who who did not even have a high school graduation. As a young girl who had financial challenges, I never envisioned higher education, let alone to be considered today the number one teacher of the world of 80,000 teachers from across 121 countries. I am also the first Black woman to win the Global Teacher Prize, which is the Nobel Prize for teachers. I say all of this to say, teachers played a huge role in my life and made me realize my true potential and possibilities of what my future could look like. I am sure you can remember at least one teacher in your life who was that champion for you. The late John Messam was that for me. He made me realize my untapped potential and the only person outside of my grandmother who told me I could be anything I wanted to be if I worked hard enough, I could achieve it. I believed him, and a year after I met him, my life changed. I was heading to college on a fully funded scholarship, and 4 years later, walk across the stage of School of Arts and Sciences graduation here on Howard campus in Burr Gymnasium. The short anecdote is to relate to you the transformative power of education and the power that you harness as educators who will shape the lives of so many young people and change the world. I know that every one of you here today have a story to tell, a place you came from, and people who influenced you. And regardless of whether you know it or not, that story will probably inform everything you do in your life in some way or another, personally and professionally. If you're lucky, it will allow you to know yourself, help people, and leave the world better than you found it. Being here again reminds me that I once sat in the place where you're sitting now. I remember that very well. Although I was very grateful for the words of wisdom in the commencement speech at my own graduation ceremony, my attention was probably overpowered by the feeling of sheer elation and relief that I had managed to graduate, that I had, in fact, made it. After 4 years of hard work, deadline, research, projects, midterm, final exams, and even though I was on a scholarship and did not have to worry about finances, those were four tough years. But I made it. Today, you did. You're now graduates, and nothing can take that away from you. It's a nice feeling, one of the best. And it's good to enjoy it while it lasts. But tomorrow, the real work begins. As you step onto the world stage to honor the values you committed to as part of this program, to serve underserved populations, to fight for social justice and equity, and create access to opportunities for those who are most vulnerable, especially those in urban school communities. That brings us all back, way back, to Howard University's motto, truth and service. During our time here, we gradually learn that the greatest goods come from our desire to be of service to others, and today we also see Howard University graduates are serving at the highest levels of government, including the vice presidency, which is truly an historic achievement. So today I urge you, do not be afraid to step into your greatness. You carry a great responsibility. You make all other professions possible. Continue to motivate, inspire, encourage, and educate the next generation of leaders. Knowing all the challenges you will face and encounter, you still chose to be an educator. You still chose to give hope to a world where education can help solve problems and broker peace. A world where a young person like me can have hope that even though education is not the only key to success, that it has power of unlocking doors of opportunity for young people to access their future. We cannot go back and change the hands of time to right all the social injustices, but what we can do from here is what matters the most. Your passing on the baton of education is a gift in so many ways. To our underrepresented people, to our underserved communities, to our exclusive society, to our inequitable system, to unequal economy, and our changing world. Realize how important the passing of the legacy of education is, because education is the great equalizer, says Horace Mann. Education is the most powerful weapon which you can use to change the world, Nelson Mandela. Education is a passport to the future, Malcolm X. Education is simply the soul of a society as it passes from one generation to another, Gilbert Keith Chesterton. Knowledge is power. Information is liberating. Education is the premise of progress in every society, in every family. Kofi Annan. When you educate one person, you change a life. When you educate many, you can change the world. Shai Rashif. He who opens a door, a school door, closes a prison. Victor Hugo. The ability to read, write, and analyze, the confidence to stand up and demand justice and equality, the qualifications and connections to get your foot into the door and take your seat at the table, all of that starts with education, Michelle Obama. And last but not least, the old Chinese proverb, if you are planning for a year, sow rice. If you are planning for a decade, plant trees. If you are planning for a lifetime, educate people. So, you see how important your role is as you walk across the stage today and take your place in the world among those who are taking action, just like other Bisons who have been pioneers and trailblazers in education, like Sterling Brown, Lucy Diggs Slow, Nora Zile Hurston, Edna Burke Jackson, and Rollin Williams. You may not be the first, but you carry the gift of change. When someone thinks of an educator, they think of just a teacher in a regular classroom delivering instructions to students. But they don't understand that you are more than that. You are a major resource to schools and communities, a strong sense of support for students and families, their mentors, their counselors, their coaches, their friends, their role models. And your classroom and offices are sometimes the only safe space a student will know. And you will probably be the only caring adult in some child's life. You are their advocates. You are not only policy influencers, but practitioners of social justice, trying to create a society that is fair and inclusive, where all students are treated equally and where all students have an opportunity to thrive. It was here at Howard University that I found my purpose. Right down the street, tutoring at a neighborhood school, and saw the needs of students that looked like me, who were marginalized and counted out. But it is the values that I learned here at Howard University that allowed me to see the needs of others and not turn a blind eye. Now it's your turn to give the gift of education, to prepare our young people for the world, and to also help break the cycle of poverty. You will be teaching them how to become global citizens, how to solve real-world problems, and how to choose peace over conflict. This may seem like a lot, but I'm confident you got this. You are here not by mistake, but by design to carry out his kingdom principles in the educational realm. God chose you to make a difference. In a profession where there's not enough recognition and acknowledgement, you were chosen to share your gift. I speak life into you right now that you were chosen for a moment such as this. You were not supposed to do anything else. You were designed for this. You can manifest anything, and all of the trials and challenges you face led you to this moment. This is your defining moment. If only you knew God, the plans God has for your life to prosper you and to give you hope and a future. So stay in the game and never let people's perception of you become your reality. You can create any reality in your life if you just push past all of your fears. Remember, while you have made it to the finish line, the finish line of this race, this is just one leg of the relay. The race continues, and you get to hand the baton to the next generation. Of all the reasons why you decide to be an educator, remember, once you've had an observation, you have an obligation. Herbert Spencer says, "The great aim of education is not knowledge, but action." And so, it's your turn to take what you have learned here into the real world and turn them into actions. And in everything you do, put God first. You have an observation, and now it's your obligation to go change the world. Of all the professions out there, just always remember, you matter, educators matter, teachers matter. Thank you.
Everyone, my name is Corvon Hill, and I have the honor of holding two titles here in SOE, the first being Mr. President, and the second being Mr. Guinea Pig. Now, the first one I don't have to explain too hard. I serve as the 2021-2022 School of Education Undergraduate Council President, and the purpose of council is to advocate for, provide resources to, and connect with SOE. My goals as president were to give a voice to SOE, recognize SOE, and to make sure that people knew what weight came with being in SOE. Through council, I did get to accomplish my presidential goals. I got to be in rooms with people like the president of Howard University. I got to serve on panels to speak to the future generations of educators and game changers, policymakers, and I also got to just meet some amazing people. Council, we got to implement the inaugural field day with the middle school right next door. We got to laugh and compete in the battle of the department's mixer, where my department did take an L, but that's okay. And we also got to provide educational and developmental opportunities to our students. And I think the joy of council was collaborating with SOE, because we in SOE have the keys to the future. Now, I'm sure you're wondering, how could somebody feel so empowered as a guinea pig? But the students empowered me, and I only hope I can empower them. I am empowered because I am the guinea pig. I'm the first student to try and will be the first student to complete the new 5-year Human Development and Masters of Social Work Partnership Program. Thank you. With this program, it's an accelerated degree program where I completed my Bachelor's of Human Development in only 3 years, and I get to pursue my 2-year MSW right across the yard at Howard University School of Social Work. The MSW from Howard was always the goal. And when Dr. LaPointe, one of our professors in the Human Development Department, came on that Zoom in May 2019 and talked about how she led to create and approve this five-year program, which meant I got to graduate sooner and save a year of tuition, I knew where I was going to end up for 5 years. And it's through that I was able to be the guinea pig of such an amazing program. I got to master all that is development, all that is the Black perspective, all that is School of Education. And I'm going to be the most prepared person in that master's program day one. And with all these titles does come many thanks. Thank you to my department and all the professors up here who created this curriculum to really get us ready to shake the world. Thank you to my fellow graduates. We ate that up together. Thank you to the families, the community, my community of my graduates for one, giving me these people to call when I need a job in the fall. And for two, the support and the love that you pour into us so we can pour into our communities. Three, thank you to the future generations. That early learning program that I worked at my freshman year, allowing new Bison to come in and let School of Education shape them and build them like they built this great class of graduates. Thank you to SOE, finally, for empowering me and building me into, well, if you know me, you know me, you know? Thank you, and congrats, class of 2022.
Good morning. Now comes the time where we will recognize our prospective graduates from the class of 2020. 2021 and 2022. Dean Williams, it is my pleasure to present the candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Science in Education from the Department of Curriculum and Instruction. At this time, will the candidates for the teacher education with a minor in secondary education please rise and come to the stage, class of 2021 and 2022. Alexander Parchment. Will the candidates for the Bachelor of Science in Elementary Education, classes 2020, 2021, and 2022, please rise and approach the stage. Abby Underwood Morrow. Jacqueline Kiyoko Jones. Aaliyah Farnham. Sydney Dennis. Salima Karoma. Amaya Martin. Jaden Jordan. Olivia Enda. Rachel Nwuzo. Diavion Cheek. Aaliyah Jeffries. Aaron Mitchell. Ashley Warren. Tierra Lynn. Congratulations to the Bachelor of Science from Curriculum and Instruction.
Dean Williams, it is my great pleasure to present the candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Science of Human Development in the Department of Human Development and Psychoeducational Studies. Will the candidates from the classes of 2020, 2021, and 2022 please rise and come forth to the stage? Suna Nayo. Corvon Hill.
Here.
Mia Raven Jackson. Makai Stevens Pruitt. Adriana Thompson. Ayana Primus. Alani Alexis Miller.
Bria Lachey Robinson. Manaya Nicole Hay. And last but certainly not least, Maya Greer. Congratulations.
For the Department of Curriculum and Instruction, will the candidates for the degree of Master's in Education, class of 2020, 2021, and 2022, elementary, special ed, and secondary ed, please rise and approach the stage. Rocket West. Veronica Williams. Aquila Walden. Delory Williams. And Tykira Dubose. Congratulations to the Department of Curriculum and Instruction.
Dean Williams, it is my pleasure to present the candidates for the degree of Master's of Education in Educational Leadership in the Department of Educational Leadership and Policy Studies. Will the candidates from the classes of 2020, 2021, and 22 please rise and approach the stage? Adrina Davon Burney. Michael D'Angelo Russell. Randamus Gonzalez. Jenny, oh, you're here. Hitson Nasser Asunbe. Poppin Ambara. Dr. Devin L.D. Mimati, Certificate of Advanced Graduate Studies. Congratulations.
Williams, it is my pleasure to present the candidates for the degree of Master of Education, in School Psychology in the Department of Human Development and Psychoeducational Studies. Will the candidates from the classes of 2020, 2021, and 2022 please rise and approach the stage? Sierra Elizabeth Brewer. Here you go. Faith Ashley Scott. Sierra Rashe Dotson. Congratulations, graduates.
Dean Williams, it is my pleasure to present the candidates for the degree of Doctorate in Education and Educational Leadership in the Department of Educational Leadership and Policy Studies, would the candidates from the classes of 2020, 21, and 22 please rise and approach the stage? Dr. Sophia Vegas, Milagros Vegas Armenos. Dissertation advisor, Dr. Christopher Rodriguez. Dr. Kiko Deontay Jave Judnot Henderson. Dr. Dr. Jabriah Akil Lewis. Dr. Michael Sherwin Brown. Dr. Shanina Cole Madonna Holland. Dr. Barbara Biasi. Dr. Amber Audrey Williams. Congratulations, graduates.
Dean Williams, it is my pleasure to present the candidates for the degree of Counseling Psychology in the Department of Human Development and Psychoeducational Studies, referred to as HDPES from henceforth. Will the candidates from the classes of 2020, 2021, and 2022 please rise and approach the stage? Dr. Nancy Aja. Dr. Parnell Minter. Dean Williams, it is now my pleasure to present the candidates for the degree of Higher Education, Leadership, and Policy Studies
in the Department of Educational Leadership and Policy Studies. Will the candidates from the classes of 2020, 2021, and 2022 please rise and approach the stage? Karen Elizabeth Bussey. Ashley Lynette Gray. Sorry. Brianna Chanel J. Clark. Dr. Cecil Duffy. Excuse me, Dr. Cecil Andrew Duffy. Dean Williams, it is my pleasure to present the candidates for the degree of Educational Psychology in the Department of HDPES. Will the candidate from the classes of 2020, 2021, and 2022 please rise and approach the stage? Dr. Karen Stephanie Gray Adams. Dean Williams, it is now my pleasure to present the candidates for the degree of school psychology in the Department of HDPES. Will the candidates from the classes of 2020, 2021, and 2022 please rise and approach the stage? Dr. Dilao Alotebi. Dr. Uhud Al-Asaf. Dr. Arden Victor Blanc Matthew. Congratulations to all the PhD students from HDPES, as well as Educational Leadership and Policy Studies.
Dean Williams. As the Academic Dean of the School of Education, it is my privilege to recognize our graduates who have demonstrated academic excellence throughout their tenure at Howard University. For honors eligibility, these specific students did not repeat courses, and for each fall and spring semester, were enrolled in at least 12 credit hours for each semester enrolled, with exception of the last semester in residence. First, I'd like to recognize our undergraduate students who have earned the cum laude honor. The cum laude graduates have earned a 3.2 to 3.49 grade point averages or higher, and will receive the gold medal of honor. Ayana Primus, Ashley Adrien Wallen. Come to the stadium to be recognized. Next, I would like to recognize our undergraduate students who have earned the magna cum laude honor. Magna cum laude graduates have earned a 3.50 to a 3.79 high honors, grade point averages or higher, and will receive the silver honor cord and the gold medal of honor. Sydney Alexandra Dennis, Alea S. Farnham, Jaden Randy Jordan, Olivia Yanaba Inda. All come to the stage, please. You recognize. Congratulations. You're welcome. Congratulations. Now I would like to recognize our undergraduate students who have earned the summa cum laude honor. The summa cum laude graduates have earned a 3.8 grade point averages or higher and will receive the gold honor cord and the gold medal of honor. Devion E. Cheek, Maya Greer, who also has a 4.0, Kovan M. Hill, Mia Raven Jackson, Rachel Surrender Olachi N. Wusu. Thank you. Congratulations. I would also like to recognize our graduate students who have earned a perfect 4.0 grade point average. These graduates will receive a gold cord and a gold medal of honor. Shaden Ganing Aladorsari, Adrina Davon Bernie, Karen Elizabeth Bussey, Tykira DeBose, Kayla N. Edwards Scott, Maya Greer, Dr. Selena Swilly Pratt, Aquila A. Wallen, Veronica J. Williams, Delore Tamara Williams. Congratulations. Now I'd like to recognize the School of Education Honor Society, Kappa Delta Pi. If you hear your names, please come to the podium. Olivia Yenaba Inda as president, Alea Farnham, vice president, Jaden Jordan, secretary, Rachel N. Wusu, treasurer, Manaya Haith, Kovan M. Hill, Jacqueline Kiyoko Jones, Alea Jesse Kinsler, Amaya Martin, Elaney Miller, Alpha DeAllo is a secondary minor, Ashley Adrene Wallen. Congratulations. Dean Williams, next I'd like to acknowledge Phi Delta Kappa, Dr. Shania Cole McDonough Holland. Please come to the podium to be recognized. Dean Williams, next I'd like to acknowledge our graduating student council member, Kovan M. Hill. Please come to the stadium. At this point, I'd like to also recognize our honor students for elementary education and human development. To hear your name, please come forward. Devion Cheek, Aaliyah Farnham, Maya Greer, Mia Jackson, Jaden Jordan, and Olivia Inda. And Miss Maya Greer had a 4.0 as an undergraduate student. Just for the note. Yes, please. Please, congratulations. We got a lot of chords here. All the best and congratulations, honor graduates. Thank you.
Hello, everyone. My name is Mia Jackson, and it is an honor to be selected to speak today to the graduating undergraduate and graduate students of the School of Education. We know that we have overcome so many obstacles to get to this point. The auditorium is filled with so many people who have helped us get here, our parents, grandparents, family members, and friends. And of course, we have our School of Education professors, administrators, and staff that taught, guided, and supported us. We want to thank everyone for continuously pouring into us and pushing us to grow into the people that we always dreamed of becoming. We all achieved a major milestone in our lives today, graduating as undergraduate and graduate students. We will launch and continue, in many cases, our careers as teachers, human service professionals, counselors, psychologists, lawyers, researchers, and entrepreneurs. As we all know, the journey through these milestones have not and will not be easy. As they say, anything worth having won't be easy. This is the first step to the road of success that we have ahead of us. We should always ask ourselves, what have we learned? First, always be eager to learn and gain new knowledge and experiences. Second, we have already achieved success. Howard University was not the beginning of our success, nor is it the end. I cannot wait to watch and hear about all of the accomplishments that we achieve over time. Third, I challenge us to continue to define and redefine our sense of purpose and achievements for ourselves and our communities. There is so much work that needs to be done. Fourth and last, being at Howard taught me that we will not always be the smartest person in the room. When you recognize that you are the smartest person in the room, I highly suggest that you find a new room. I will conclude with words from Shirley Chisholm, the first Black woman elected in the United States Congress. She said, "You don't make progress by standing on the sidelines, whimpering and complaining. You make progress by implementing ideas." As I close, I urge you all to continue to be the change makers we have been proven to be. Continue learning, be creative, serve our communities, and most importantly, continue to just be you. You have everything that you need to be the best version of yourself. I am so thankful that my Howard experience has been spent with HU22.
Good morning. My name is Adrena Burney, and I am so elated to present the class charge today at this momentous occasion. Class of 22, y'all, we did it. And I am so proud. To say the least, this journey has been one that we could have never imagined. When I look back on these last 2 years, it can only make me chuckle. Y'all know. For some of you, you had the chance to be on campus and get the HU experience. But from my cohort, we attended Howard Zoom School for most of our experience. We knew each other by the small squares on the screen, our living room spaces, and the many different sounds we would hear when someone forgot to press mute. Though our circumstances were not quite how we expected, our passion never changed to make a difference. Yes, I know that might sound a bit cliche because we're all in the broad field of education. So that is already the goal, right? But I am speaking about that fiery passion, the one that reminds you of your why. The why that enabled us to push through a pandemic. That why that gave us the extra push when you felt like you could not make it. And that same why that brought us all here today. We each have a passion that is bubbling inside of us, ready to reignite again to continue our purpose. When I look at each of you, I do not just see graduates. I see purpose builders, whether in the forms of educators, administrators, human service professionals, social workers, psychologists, researchers, ministers, or entrepreneurs. We each have a passion and a purpose, and we are desperately needed in our communities regionally, nationally, and globally. So when you step from Howard University, keep your same passion and drive for our communities. Always remember that we have the power to change today's and tomorrow's institutional systems. We have young and older brown and black economically marginalized people who need us. So be a voice, mentor, advocate, and world changer. To my family, who didn't know I was speaking today, so surprise. I thank you all for your support, helping me keep my dreams alive, and being here with me today. Thank you, Howard University and the School of Education, for opening spaces to remind us of our history, worth, and power. To my professors, who became like family, thank you. And to my peers, always remember that we have the power no matter what. So continue to gain knowledge and keep that same energy. Congratulations.
Good morning. Good morning. Hi. My name is Parnell Minter, and I was tasked to do the charge today for the doctoral class. Because it's a long journey to this moment, I'm naturally indebted to a countless number of people, some of whom are in this room today, and I do want to recognize them briefly. The good book says, when a man finds a woman, a wife, he finds a good thing, and he receives favor from the Lord. So I do want to honor my wife, who's in the audience as well, taking pictures for me. The good book also says, honor your mother and your father so your days may be long. So I want to honor my mother and my father who are here as well. So with that being said, my charge to you all today, everyone under the sound of my voice really, is to have an undeniable belief in yourself and an unmovable belief in God. As you continue to pursue your purpose in this life, always believe in yourself no matter the circumstances. A few weeks ago, I was doing my pre-defense, about a month ago, and I thought it didn't go too well. And I stepped out of the room and the committee convened, and I was out and I was all in my thoughts. And one of the thoughts that came to mind is said, I can't believe that they asked me to do the charge. I'm not going to graduate because I didn't think I passed the pre-defense. But when I came back in the room, my advisor, Dr. Ukta, said on behalf of the committee, Dr. Middleton, Dr. Woodson, Dr. Ebanks, and Dr. Watkins Law, she said, we believe in you. And I immediately recalled that not only do they believe in me, but I believe in myself. Not only do I believe in myself, I believe in God. So that reminded me of what he had told me when I came to school, that he was going to see me through. And in this life, you're going to have your situation to come up. You're going to have trials that come. Rain's going to come. Disappointments are going to happen. But you got to remember this. You can't trust in your senses. You can't trust in how it looks. You can't trust in how it might feel at that moment. You can't trust in how it might seem. You got to trust in God. And the most important thing you got to do is, it's in these three scriptures that I love to stand on. It says, now unto him who is able to do exceedingly, abundantly, above all you can ask or think, according to the power that is at work within you all. Also it says, now unto him who is able to keep you from falling, can present you faultless with exceeding great joy. And my last one, now unto him who will prepare a table before you in the presence of your enemies. Congratulations, you all.
Good morning. Good morning. If I can have the class of 2020, 2021, and 2022, please stand and raise your right hand. You're going to repeat after me with all the boldness inside of you. As an alumnus or alumna of the Howard University School of Education, I will at all times and in all places promote the good name and reputation of the Howard University School of Education. With dignity, I will demonstrate the character and consciousness, exercise leadership, and strive to open new doors of opportunity for the generations behind me. I will assist the School of Education by recruiting worthy students, donating financially, resources, and by speaking about Black and marginalized communities in an uplifting and empowering manner. Beginning today, as a son or daughter of the world-renowned institution, I wholeheartedly support the Howard University School of Education future with my time and treasure. This I do pledge. Congratulations.
Getting ready for the recessional. We will sing our O Howard song, and then the faculty will lead us down this aisle. The students will follow the faculty. We will go out this left door, across the yard, and to the rooftop of the undergraduate library for some wonderful refreshments. See you over there.